My name is Igwebu Zaurika. I'm from Enugu State. My dad is late, but my mom is alive. Actually, I was living with my elder sister before she got married. She's still here in Port Harcourt, but not staying with her. She said that I should come and stay with her in her husband's place, but I told her no, that I want to be on my own. So I was staying alone before I got pregnant. Then I told her about it. She was not happy. She called the guy, but the guy told her that he cannot cater for the baby, that I should do away with the baby. That if not, he cannot do anything, he cannot cater for the baby. She came to me and told me everything that she discussed with the guy. She was so much angry with me that each time she had to remind me. So what happened was that she had an accommodation problem where she used to stay. So she moved in to back to where we are staying before, because I was not staying there with her husband and children. So that time I was very ill, very, very ill, that I could not move or go anywhere. I expected my sister to look after me, but she did not. She left me there. It was an outsider that took care of me. I explained to him. At first he thought I was joking, but when he saw that I was serious, he told me to go and abort the baby. In the time she left me, I moved into my neighbor's place. She had to feed me and feed her children and her family also. Along the line, I have to call back the woman I worked at house help for her. I explained everything to her. She said that there is no problem, that I can come back to her and work for her. But it's not that I'm actually working for her. She's doing it to help me. I'm not doing anything for her. At the end of the world, she finds me something. I never told me about Sophie. Although I've been seeing it on television, but it was through my neighbor that I came to this school. What made me to come to OPM is because I don't have money to go to a bigger hospital to go and register. Sometimes I find it hard to feed. It's people around that gives me food. The first day I came here, I don't know the particular date that they do registration. So I came, they told me to go, that it's not the day for registration. I went back. They told me the day I'll come back, so I came back that day that they told me. So when I came, they have to do scan. Hospital has been good, especially the workers. They are kind, they are nice to everybody. They don't discriminate, they don't ask which church or all that. They are good, as in the way they treat this person, that is how they treat the other. They are very good. They did not charge me any money. They did not ask for any money. Since when I came to this place, nobody have asked me for 5 naira. They don't ask for money for anything. Everything is free. So it's true CS. The consultants have advised me to go into CS because the best way to save both me and my baby was through CS. They handed my baby placenta to me. They have given me half. I worship at Catholic Church. They treated me well and normal, the way they treat every other person. I have to say thank you to God for everything, at least. At the end of everything, I'm happy that all what I went through was not in vain. God really saw me through. I'm alive and my baby is alive. I thank God for that. The only thing I have to say to him is that God should bless him. Keep him alive to continue to do his good work here on this earth. And as long as he's alive, let God continue to pour his fresh anointing upon him. Give him that grace and power. Let him continue to move on and do the work of God. And I pray that at the end of this life, that heaven will be his portion in Jesus' name. I advise to other girls out there, we should keep our legs tight. We should hold on to God and wait for the right time that he prepared for us. It's not easy. It's not easy at all. Even though you have somebody to help you, it's not easy.
Look how you turned my life around. And wipe my tears, unchangeable God, unchangeable.